أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
عبس وتولى.
The prophet frowned and turned away.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم عبس وتولى. He, that is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, frowned and turned aside.
أن جاءه الأعمى.
Because there came to him the blind man interrupting.
أن جاءه الأعمى. Because there came to him the blind man. Now the incident in the background is that once the Prophet was busy talking to the chiefs of Quraysh. Important people, noble. As we have read many a times, he had more attention towards them, because if they accept Iman and Islam, then you know Islam would be strengthened. And also the plight and condition of the downtrodden Muslims, the slaves, etc., they could be better. If these people who have a high position in the society, if they come in the fold of Islam. So that was only the only cause for which the Prophet used to pay attention to them. But it so happened when he was busy, Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umm Maktoum radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he was first cousin of Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, and he was a blind person. He came, and he wanted to address the Prophet. He wanted that the Prophet should listen to him. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt it. He didn't like it. I'm busy here, and he wants my attention. But because he was blind, he couldn't see the situation. He again tried to address him. On that, there were stones on the forehead of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, frowning. So for displeasure, the sign of displeasure appeared on his face. He, the Prophet, frowned and turned aside. He didn't turn towards Abdullah ibn Umm Maktoum, but his attention was diverted toward the same chiefs.
وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّهُ
يَزَّكَّى. But what would make you perceive, O Muhammad, that perhaps he might be purified?
وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّهُ يَزَّكَّى. And how could you realize that it might be that he might have purified himself? Abdullah ibn Umm Maktoum, he is coming to you, he wants to talk to you. It was just possible that your giving attention to him would have purified him.
أَوْ يَذَّكَّرُ فَتَنْفَعَهُ الذِّكْرَى.
Or be reminded, and the remembrance would benefit him.
أَوْ يَذَّكَّرُ. Or he might have got some admonition, some reminding. فَتَنْفَعَهُ الذِّكْرَى. And the admonition might have profited him.
As for he who thinks himself without need.
Amma man istaghna. As for those who is not paying any heed to you.
فَأَنْتَ لَهُ تَصَدَّى.
To him you give attention.
فَأَنْتَ لَهُ تَصَدَّى. You are attending to them very attentively.
وَمَا عَلَيْكَ أَلَّا يَزَّكَّى.
And not upon you is any blame if he will not be purified.
وَمَا عَلَيْكَ أَلَّا يَزَّكَّى. And there is no blame on you if they are not purifying themselves. You are not responsible for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to question you. Why didn't they accept your message? Well, the responsibility is theirs. But they are not paying attention. They show there is no inclination whatsoever. But you are trying and trying and trying.
وَأَمَّا مَنْ جَاءَكَ يَسْعَى.
But as for he who came to you striving for knowledge.
وَأَمَّا مَنْ جَاءَكَ يَسْعَى. And who comes to you running eagerly. He wants to benefit from your company, from your talk, from conversation that he can have with you.
وَهُوَ يَخْشَى
while he fears Allah.
وَهُوَ يَخْشَى. And he has a fear of Allah in his heart.
فَأَنْتَ عَنْهُ تَلَهَّى.
From him you are distracted.
فَأَنْتَ عَنْهُ تَلَهَّى. To him you pay no heed.
أَلَّا إِنَّهَا تَذْكِرَهُ.
No, indeed, these verses are a reminder.
Kalla, don't do this. Don't take to this attitude. Inna tazkira. Verily, this Quran is only an admonition and reminding.
فَمَنْ شَاءَ ذَكَرَهُ.
So whoever wills may remember it.
فَمَنْ شَاءَ ذَكَرَهُ. So whosoever wants, let him be reminded. Let him be admonished. Let him remember.
It is recorded in honored sheets.
في صحف مكرمة. These ayat over here, you know, the majesty of Quran, it is described here, as we have seen, إِنَّهُ لَقُرْآنٌ كَرِيمٌ فِي كِتَابٍ مَكْنُونٌ لَا يَمَسُّهُ إِلَّا الْمُطَهَّرُونَ. If you recall, in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, then we had, إِنَّهُ فِي أُمِّ الْكِتَابِ لَدَيْنَا لَعَلِيٌّ حَكِيمٌ. In the same way here, you know, فِي صُحُفٍ مُكَرَّمَةٍ. This Quran is inscribed in records which are greatly honored.
مَرْفُوعَةٍ مُطَهَّرَةٍ.
Exalted and purified.
مَرْفُوعَةٍ مُطَهَّرَةٍ. Exalted. Kept pure and holy.
بِأَيْدِي سَفَرَةٍ.
Carried by the hands of messenger angels.
بِأَيْدِي سَفَرَةٍ. In the hands of the writers. And who are those writers?
قَامٍ بَرَرَةٍ.
Noble and dutiful.
Kiramim Barara. The angels who are noble and virtuous. So this is the situation, this is the position of this Quran. You don't, you know, don't, so to say, dishonor it by offering the, in this way. And you know, so to say, you are running behind these rich people and the chiefs, taking Quran with you in your hand or presenting to them Quran. Quran is a very honorable thing. So whosoever wants, okay, he has the right that this message should be conveyed to him. But whosoever feels no interest, no inclination, let him go where he goes.
قُتِلَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا أَكْفَرَهُ.
Destroyed is man. How disbelieving is he?
قُتِلَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا أَكْفَرَهُ. That's to man. How ungrateful is he?
مِنْ أَيِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَهُ.
From what substance did he create him?
مِنْ أَيِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَهُ. Of what thing, out of what did he create him? He never thinks.
مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ خَلَقَهُ فَقَدَّرَهُ.
From a sperm drop he created him and destined for him.
Min nutfa, out of a sperm drop, khalaqahu faqaddarahu. He created it from that and then molded him in proper proportions.
Thumma as-sabila yassarah.
Then he eased the way for him.
Thumma as-sabila yassarahu. Then made the way easy for him. The way, what does it mean? Maybe the process of birth. Coming out of the womb of the mother into this world. Breathing in this atmosphere. This is also a very difficult way, but Allah makes it easy. Then, you know, passing through this world, there are difficulties. We shall read, إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. But a man is accustomed to it, and then, you know, he passes the whole life. ثُمَّ السَّبِيلَ يَسَّرَهُ.
ثُمَّ أَمَاتَهُ فَأَقْبَرَهُ.
Then he causes his death and provides a grave for him.
ثُمَّ أَمَاتَهُ Then he made him die, فَأَقْبَرَهُ and got him buried.
ثُمَّ إِذَا شَاءَ أَنْشَرَهُ
Then when he wills, he will resurrect him.
ثُمَّ إِذَا شَاءَ أَنْشَرَهُ And after that, whenever he wills, he shall raise him. Now the former things, which one of those were easy? Creating a man out of a sperm drop, was an easy job? This birth, do you think it's an easy process? How Allah has, you know, made it easy? Then everything that is going on before your eyes, each thing is very difficult, if you think. Only because you see them day and night. So you think you take them for granted. But if you think and ponder, everything is very great. And everything is a symbol of Allah's omnipotence, that He has all authority and all power. ثُمَّ أَمَاتَهُ فَأَكْبَرَهُ ثُمَّ إِذَا شَاءَ أَنْشَرَهُ It's the second step, that's all.
كَلَّا لَمَّا يَقْضِ مَا أَمَرَهُ
No, man has not yet accomplished what he commanded him.
كَلَّا لَمَّا يَقْضِ مَا أَمَرَهُ No, but man has not fulfilled what his Lord has commanded him. The Lord has commanded, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ And we made the covenant before coming into this world. أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ But man does not fulfill the covenant. He does not fulfill what God commands him.
فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِهِ
Then let mankind look at his food.
فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِهِ Once before, the attention to your own creation. Now look to the food that you eat. فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِهِ Let this man look at his food.
أَنَّا صَبَبْنَا الْمَاءَ صَبَّا
How we poured down water in torrents.
أَنَّا صَبَبْنَا الْمَاءَ صَبًّا It is we who poured down water abundantly. Who brought down the rain? Ourselves.
ثُمَّ شَقَقْنَا الْأَرْضَ شَقًّا
Then we broke open the earth, splitting it with sprouts.
ثُمَّ شَقَقْنَا الْأَرْضَ شَقًّا Then we splitted the earth in clefts. فَأَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا حَبًّا And then we made the grain to grow.
وَعِنَبًا وَقَضْبًا
And grapes and herbage.
وَعِنَبًا وَقَضْبًا And the grapes and the palm trees. وَعِنَبًا وَقَضْبًا And the grapes and vegetables.
وَزَيْتُونًا وَنَخْلًا
And olive and palm trees.
وَزَيْتُونًا وَنَخْلًا And the olive trees and the palm trees.
وَحَدَائِقَ غُلْبًا
And gardens of dense shrubbery.
وَحَدَائِقَ غُلْبًا And walled gardens of dense growth.
وَفَاكِهَةً وَأَبَّا
And fruit and grass.
وَفَاكِهَةً وَأَبَّا And all sorts of fruits and fodder.
مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ
As enjoyment for you and your grazing livestock.
مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ وَلِأَنْعَامِكُمْ Again that ayah repeated. And all this is a provision for you and for your cattle.
فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةُ
But when there comes the deafening blast,
فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةُ Again compare. There was فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الطَّامَّةُ الْكُبْرَى In Surah An-Nazi'at. And here it is, فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةُ Then when the deafening cry will come out.
يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ
On the day a man will flee from his brother.
يَوْمَ يَفِرُ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ. On that day, man will run away from his brother.
وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ.
And his mother and his father.
وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ. And his mother and his father.
وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ.
And his wife and his children.
وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ. And from his wife and his children.
لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ.
For every man that day will be a matter adequate for him.
لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. Every one of them that day shall have enough concern of his own to make him indifferent or unmindful of others. This is what we call in some of the tradition, nafsi, nafsi. Everybody will be thinking about himself. And we have read in Surah Al-Ma'arij, يُبَصُّرُونَهُمْ يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَأَخِيهِ وَفَصِيلَتِهِ الَّتِي تُوْوِيهِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ يُنْجِيهِ. Take all humanity, put it in hell, please save me anyhow. This will be the condition. But we should think here. We have beloveds, sons, daughters, wives, husbands, parents, and for them, for pleasing them, we do wrong things. We earn through prohibited means. For them, to provide for them a better living, to provide a better education for the children. We indulge in all things, in riba, so that they can have more comfortable, big mansion to live. Okay, go and have in mortgage, have a house. But on that day, you will be thinking about your own self. What should be our attitude here? Here also we should first of all think of our own salvation, then the salvation of others. But there is circle. First of all, you own qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara, and also your family. Then wa anzir ashiratakal aqrabin, then a broader circle, your relatives, your kith and kin. Then your nation, maybe your tribe, then the all mankind. But this should go in this sequence. Not that you are going and, you know, and calling others to the deen of Allah and forgetting your own family. You don't think where they are going. And you are living happily with them. Although their direction is absolutely opposite to the direction of deen. But still your instinctive love for them, that is there. So what will happen? يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. Now again we have here a picture of the day of resurrection, as we had in Surah Al-Qiyamah. In the same way,
وجوه يومئذ مسفرة.
Some faces that day will be bright.
وجوه يومئذ مسفرة. Many faces on that day shall be beaming, shining, glittering, glaring.
ضاحكة مستبشرة.
Laughing, rejoicing at good news.
ضَاحِكَةٌ مُسْتَبْشِرَةٌ. Laughing, rejoicing. People who believed. And because every nafs, every soul would be knowing where it stands. بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا. Although it has not been declared, but they know it. What is going to be declared for us? So those who are going to be successful, declared successful, already on their faces, you find, you know, those signs of success.
ووجوه يومئذ عليها غبرة.
and other faces that day will have upon them dust.
وَوُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَلَيْهَا غَبَرَةٌ. Many faces on that day shall have dust upon them.
تَرْهَقُهَا قَتَرَةٌ.
Blackness will cover them.
تَرْهَقُهَا قَتَرَةٌ. Darkness will be overspread over them.
أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَفَرَةُ الْفَجَرَةُ.
Those are the disbelievers, the wicked ones.
أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَفَرَةُ الْفَجَرَةُ. Those, they will be the disbelievers and the miscreants.